'Twas the night before Christmas, and I'm not lying. For Christmas dinner, we're opening a bottle of Sassicaia. All right, well, that was a pretty corny opening, but I really liked the way it came out. I kind of thought that one out today, and I was like, I'm going to use it anyhow, so forgive me. But yes, it's Christmas Day, and I'm going to open up a bottle of Sassicaia. I have a vertical in my wine cellar. I've had them for several years. I have 11 through 15, and I have a dilemma I need to fix. Actually, I have two dilemmas. The first is the 2016 just came out, and it's rated 100 points by Robert Parker, but that's driven the price up considerably. And I'm kind of at the point where I just don't want to spend that kind of money for a bottle of wine that just sits on my shelf. And that's my second dilemma. I collect all these nice bottles and I look at them, but I'm afraid to open them because then it ruins my vertical. So I just kind of look at them, and that's a lot of money to spend on wine that you don't even drink. So we're going to solve both of those issues. I am not going to buy the 2016. We're going to stop the vertical. And number two is, I'm going to open up this first one. It's 2011 Sassicaia, and we're going to have it for dinner today. Now, Sassicaia, well, I'll show you this bottle first off. It's a beautiful label. And this is a super Tuscan, and that breaks the rules of Italian winemaking from years ago. So this particular wine has a lot of those Bordeaux-style varietals like Cabernet Sauvignon and Merlot. And so this is going to go really, really good with the rib roast that Leah is going to be making today. So I'm excited to try this wine. All right, well, the way I've been decanting wines as of late is to use this aerator that we reviewed this a couple years ago and just putting it into my decanter, and we'll just kind of run it through the aerator here into the decanter. And there's a little bit of a filter there to catch whatever material might still be in the wine. And we're just going to let this sit in the aerator, I'm sorry, in the decanter for, oh, a good hour. Yeah, and then we'll come back and taste this. First off, the color is ruby red.
It's a really dark red. Kind of like a lush red velvet. Oh, there's red currants and black currants, or cassis. Mm-hmm. I mean, this smells like some of my black currant liqueur.
I get gobs of red fruit.
I get
jammy.
Yep.
Very jammy.
A vanilla.
Beautiful nose.
Mm-hmm.
Very intense. It's very complex.
How long has this been decanted?
About an hour.
Okay, so a good time frame. I'm ready.
I know.
It's hard to drink something
to
that's
get a lot
so
of
expensive.
A lot of firm tannins. Well, it has a lot of time left to age in the bottle, a lot of time.
That's so actually my thought too.
Yeah, this is 2019, that was the 2011.
It's a little harsh initially. I feel like it's tight. I wonder how it would be, whether it's in the decanter, or if it was in our glasses a little bit longer. It's inky.
Yep.
It's kind of strong.
Almost a little bitter.
Yeah, it's a little austere.
Mm-hmm.
And it lingers, it gets lighter with the finish. And you get more of those red fruits as well.
It has a very long, long lasting finish.
It'll be interesting to see how this develops as we have it with our prime rib for dinner. And if that will go well, if the wine will open up with time, because we still have to put the prime rib in the oven, so it'll have a lot of time to open up.
Oh, but wait, there's more. So this wine with dinner really became a lot more epic. A lot of the flavors that we were tasting in the cellar were there, but it was a lot more rounded. A lot of the currants, they weren't really as strong. All those acid flavors, they just kind of mellowed out. And that's because this was decanted for nearly 3 hours before we sat down to eat. And those tannins that we were tasting, well, they were still there, but they really weren't as strict as what we were sensing in the wine cellar. It was definitely a wine that has a lot of growth yet, and you could probably still leave this in your cellar for at least 5-10 years before you drink it. So Sassicaia 2011, really a very nice wine. I'm glad that I opened it, because, you know, what's the purpose of having a wine like this if you're not going to make memories with it? And I had my parents over, and they're getting a little bit older, and I wanted to share this wine with them. So glad that I opened it. So from our family to yours, we wish you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We'll see you on our next Wine Forecaster video.